MS-223 is located in the South Bronx area, which is the poorest congressional district in the country. There are 31 students in the class. Most of them are Latino. Amongst the Latinos that we have, there is a wide variety. I use the students' culture in almost every lesson that I do. I use their names, I'll use their heritage. And then the other Samis, which are the?
Mariachi.
Okay, good.
Mr. Arcos has brought culture into the classroom in a number of different ways. And our students are from many different places, so being able to bring in their families lets the students see how they're similar and also what the differences are, and looking at that and studying it and celebrating it.
Even though it is a math class, it's important for me to be cognizant of the students' English reading levels, because I have to know, is this really a numeracy problem or is it a literacy problem?
Five, you got this. Fist, I need help, okay? Fist to five, show me with your hands.
So they know that they have language partners in math class that they are working with. And so I'll pair a high student with a medium student to scaffold them to grow this way, and a low student with a medium student, again, to get them to grow to proficiency. The students are gonna get there, and they do get there. We're all getting there together. When students know that you have a close relationship with families, that you can say hi to them on the street, that you talk to them on the phone, that they're welcome to come into the classroom, they feel more comfortable with you as well.
Mr. Arcos makes us feel like a family and team. We solve our problems and everything.
You're always gonna have to work together because you are a team and a family.
So the students are welcome to take risks, and it's important to take risks in learning. Without reflection and team building, you have that atmosphere where students feel comfortable and take risks and hold each other accountable.
Good morning, team and family.
Good morning, Karen.
I apologize to Mr. Arcos and everybody here for interrupting the things he was talking about and interrupting everybody. Do you accept my apology?
Yes.
Thank you. If you're coming from behind, like most of my students are, you have to put in more time in order to get to that same level. And I'm here to support the students in that way.
I want you to say yet after that, okay? So go ahead and say it again, Caroline.
I'm not going to spend this yet.
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 Do you know how that makes
future,
it different?
Now you don't know, but in the future you will know better.
Nice, which is our big goal, right?
I know there is an urgency. If you look at literacy rates, it's a crisis, especially here in the community of the South Bronx. So I know that this is where I need it. And what I'm doing is providing the support to my students so that they can break the stereotypes, so that they can excel, they can get into the best high schools and into the best universities and break the cycle of poverty so that we can uplift the community.